Hi, my name is Josie, and I'm a girl, and I have a penis.
What would you do if your 8-year-old son told you he wanted to be a girl?
Right now, in the perfect world, she'd go to sleep with her penis and then wake up with a vagina.
What do you want to be when you grow up?
A mommy.
An increasing number of children are being brought up as the opposite sex.
That's mine.
What happens when your son becomes your daughter?
It really did take quite a bit of time for me to accept that I don't really have a son. I never really had a son. This is a daughter.
You look like a beautiful little girl.
If I had to wear boys' clothes and be a boy for the rest of my life, I would probably die.
I can't even imagine a girl standing right there in the mirror like that, because I just can't. Because, you know, this is who I am.
See a smile.
Josie Romero is 8 years old and lives in Tucson, Arizona. Josie is a boy and used to be called Joseph. Since the age of 6, her parents have allowed her to live as a girl.
Beautiful girl.
No, you are.
No, you are the beautiful girl.
No, you are.
Is it fun for you and Vanessa to do her hair?
Oh, yeah. I love it. Yeah, because she looks in the mirror when she's done and she's so happy with what she sees. I like that. There you go, beautiful.
I'm done.
Yay!
Careful. Go ahead and take it.
Josie lives with her mom, dad, and adopted sister, Jade.
Come in, that's enough. Okay.
For years, her parents tried to make her dress and act like a boy.
You can? Oh.
But she was adamant she was a girl.
Josie's always wanted to change her body. And she'd put on my bra and she'd put like things inside of it. And any way that she could, she'd morph her body.
What would you like to happen to your body when you grow up?
I would like to get boobs when I grow up.
Why do you want boobs?
Looks cute. Hey, what's this? This is me playing bowling.
Mm-hmm. She looks at her penis as a birth defect. She wants to have it fixed. But right now, Josie's afraid of pain. She really hates pain. So when she asked me if when she has her surgery, is it going to be painful, I told her it will. Who would do it?
Your doctor.
Right.
Of course.
Yeah. If you had it done, how would they do it? Would you, like, talk to the doctor a bunch of times?
Yeah.
Yeah? And
then they push the penis in.
They push it in. Yeah, they make it inside out. And what does that make?
A vagina?
Yeah.
How?
Because the penis is, like, inside out. They just flip it inside out.
Is the vagina inside out to me?
Right, yours is like inside out. Yours is backwards. Your vagina like grew out instead of in, huh?
By the time Josie reached the age of 6, her determination to be a girl was causing her behavior to become erratic.
If she was alone in her room, then she could be as feminine as she wanted to be, and nobody was saying, oh, you're a funny boy, or, you know, trying to masculinate her in any way. But as soon as we'd interact, as soon as we'd even praise her using a male pronoun, she would just lose it. She would throw herself down. She would cry hysterically. I mean, the biggest tantrum you can imagine. She ripped the paper off the walls of her bedroom. caught her in the bathroom. She was in there for ages, so I went in to find out what she was doing. And she was standing there with her nail clippers in one hand and her penis in the other. And she was looking at herself like she was trying to build up the courage to just do it. And it was terrifying.
There.
Josie was taken to a doctor and diagnosed with gender dysphoria, a condition where children and adults feel that they are trapped in the body of the wrong sex. Josie is one of the youngest to receive this diagnosis. Her parents saw no alternative but to allow her to become a girl. Joseph's name was legally changed to Josie.
It was really a mourning time for me because I like lost my child. It was my son. And there was a long time I didn't know what to do. I mean, I'd go to work, I would carry on about my business, but inside I was just devastated over the loss.
We forced her. I made her fit into a role that isn't hers. I forced her to be a boy that she isn't.
Hard to think about now.
Yeah, it's like abuse. I really abused her. I don't want to do any harm.
Oh, Mama, look at this. Oh, these are cute. These are definitely not my size, though. I am very, very girly, and I dress like all in pink. Very, very lots of pink.
Kyla Leckold is an 8-year-old boy, but for as long as she can remember, she has believed she is a girl.
I really want this skirt.
Well, you can just try it on.
Oh, I love this. That's mine. I like sparkly stuff.
Look at this one, it has sparkles.
Oh. Sparkle denim, cool.
You wanna try it?
Yeah. I wear lots of jewelry sometimes. Bangles, bracelets, necklaces, earrings. I just got my ears pierced, so.
I'm getting a bunch of stuff.
Kyla has gender dysphoria.
That'd be cute with some pink tights or some white tights. That's pretty short, holy cow.
Hey, get her?
We'll think about that one. I never thought I would be buying girl clothes, ever.
It's summer break, and Kyla is in Alta, California.
You lost it.
Kyla's parents accepted her femininity as a toddler and have allowed her to dress as a girl at home.
When Kaya first started learning how to speak and everything, and she started forming sentences, you know, there's usually that question, you know, where did I come from? You know, how was I made? And Kaya's question was like, why was I born a boy?
We thought, you know, we just had a gay boy. That's what we figured, and that's fine with us, you know. My husband's brothers are both gay. I had lots of uncles that were gay, you know, so that was not a big deal to us. That was something we knew.
I don't have a 6, a 5, or a 0.
After Kyla was diagnosed with gender dysphoria, her parents decided to let her start living as a girl. Her name was changed from Kai to Kyla, and everyone in the family had to get used to calling him a her.
It was very hard adjusting to the pronouns and her new name, but after 2 weeks worth of it was pretty easy. I kind of like her as a sister because she's a lot sassier. She'll be all sassy when she talks like that.
You just made me more lucky. Oh,
sucker.
Kai, look at this. Look.
Oh.
Isn't she pretty?
Yeah, she is pretty.
For children like Kai, there are hormone treatments available to help them grow up to look like a girl. 16-year-old Kim Petras is the youngest child in the world to have had a sex change.
I can't imagine her as a boy, really.
Oh, she started hormones at 12. Female hormones. What do you think about female hormones?
Oh my gosh.
Do you remember what'll happen when you take female hormones?
I won't go through men's puberty.
That and what else? What will happen?
I'll start to look like a girl.
Uh-huh.
I'll go through girl's puberty.
Yeah. Yep.
Oh, yay.
And we'll get to buy a bra.
Yay. I want to be a girl. Make me a girl, please.
For Kai to develop as a woman, medical treatment must begin before her body goes through the irreversible changes of male puberty. The first step is to take drugs to prevent her body from developing into a man's.
What we're offering is to extend childhood, in a sense, or to at least extend the physicality of pre-puberty while they're getting older enough to be able to make more complex decisions.
If at the end of a couple of years, the gender dysphoria persists and it's very strong and the child wants to be the other sex, then cross-sex hormones are introduced.
When the child is given these hormones, they begin to go through the puberty of the opposite sex. For girls, this means their voices deepen and they grow facial hair. And for boys, their testicles shrink and they develop breasts. Since Josie was 6 years old, she's been growing her hair and dressing as a girl. Now at age 8, puberty is looming, and she'll soon have to decide if she wants to take the puberty blockers and begin the journey to becoming a woman.
Josie's really eager to get the shape of an older girl because her friends are getting breast buds. She wants that. They have a little bit more of a girly shape than she does because they're just starting to enter puberty themselves.
Hold still. Josie, I want to talk about puberty. Do you know what that means?
Mm-hmm.
What?
Getting boobs.
Yeah, I know, that's your favorite thing, isn't it?
Uh-huh, and getting hair on your privates.
Yeah, that'll happen too. Hold still. We smeared your blue a bunch. So Josie, for you to get breasts, you need to have estrogen. Your body won't do it by itself. Remember how the doctor was talking about it the other day? That you're gonna have to start getting the shots?
Oh, I don't like shots. How else do they have medicine for shots?
But that medicine that you take, you have to take it from a shot.
To get boobs?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
You didn't ever tell me that.
Yeah, I thought I did.
No. I'm not gonna get surgery.
Yeah, to get them. You can take a shot instead. We're almost ready for the green. A lot of people say to me, how can you let her choose this? Isn't she too young to know? But she's not. I mean, when I was a little girl, I always knew I was a girl. When I was 4 years old, I knew I was a girl. I can see pictures of myself at that age. Josie knew she was a girl, too.
Do you think this could be a phase?
We wanted it to be a phase. It would have been a lot more comfortable for us if it were a phase. Joseph especially really wanted this to be a phase, something that she could outgrow that wouldn't cause her pain later in life, because it's caused her a lot of pain. Josie's gone through a lot of turmoil to be true to who she is, but she's consistently stayed that way. She's braved it every single time. Every time anybody's tried to argue it with her, she's always come out and held fast to the fact that she is a female, that she is a girl.
How do you feel about having a penis?
Grumpy.
Grumpy? What do you wish would happen?
Just magically a vagina comes.
Yeah, that would be so nice.
It's wrong having a penis when you're a girl.
It's wrong to have a penis if you're a girl?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense, huh? It's kind of like a birth defect. Here, let me see
this
one.
It is a birth defect.
Mm-hmm. Let me see this one.
Do you think that the fact there is treatment available to help Josie become a girl could be encouraging her to become one?
If this were to happen 20 years ago, and society just refused to allow her to grow her hair and get her ears pierced and change her name, if there was just no way for Josie to be who she truly is, then I think she would have struggled with it to the best of her ability as long as she could have, which was maybe another year or two. So I know without a doubt we would have lost her by now.
How does that make you feel?
That's the only thing that's scarier than when I walked in on her with the nail clippers.
Is enjoying the last few weeks of her summer break as a girl.
I have been dancing since I was 2. I taught myself how to dance.
Kai doesn't repress herself at all, and she was going to start dressing as a girl whether we wanted it or not.
At school, Kai has been dressing as a boy. But her feminine behavior has caused her problems on the playground.
One time, a bunch of these girls in my class tried to form a cheerleading squad. I really wanted to be on it, but they wouldn't let me. This really obnoxious kid that went to my school, he was riding his bicycle right next to us and saying, "Kai, you look like a girl. Come on. Get out of those clothes," and stuff like that. He was the most obnoxious kid ever. I just had to go with it. I was really mad at him, though.
Despite Kai's difficulties at school, her parents have agreed to allow her to start the new term as a girl.
Some people are like, you can't have her go to school because, you know, she's going to get teased and this and that. And then other people are like, oh, it's not a big deal. It's going to be fine. And, you know, the principal's kind of like, you know, we're not going to allow any bullying. All the teachers are going to know that they have to make sure they're using female pronouns and using her female name and everything. But I have really mixed feelings about it.
Excited and worried about school. I'm excited because I'm going to identify as a girl. I'm worried because I'm going to be afraid that people are going to tease me.
However young it was, how big and important and heavy decision
was it? Well, now when I think back on it, it was pretty, like I said, it was overwhelming for me, but it was just, I think I remember now spending a few days being just absolutely terrified of what was going to happen when we tried to tell people about it.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I didn't know what to do.
That is still terrifying for me.
Yeah.
It is absolutely terrifying for me. I feel like I'm almost asking for permission. Like, my son is now a girl. Is it okay with you?
Yeah.
Which is totally ridiculous, but I feel... It's terrifying to me.
Is this your first time at Visions? Yeah? Let me pop the German.
With school about to start, Kai has been given a treat.
I like my hair very, very much, and I want to grow it long, so long that I can braid it, put ponytails in it, pigtails. Especially pigtails.
What do you want to do today?
I was going to get some highlights.
Some highlights? Okay. Do you like it kind of stripey, or do you just like them to be real tiny like you've been out in the sun?
Stripey.
Kind of stripey? Okay.
Hair is everything. It's like that is what being female means to them almost. That like embodies all of being a girl is that hair. And so some other moms I've heard have gotten wigs for their kids too, just so they'll be able to go out and feel better. Kyla was born as a boy and she's a transgender child.
Oh, really?
Yes.
So this is her, we've been letting her hair grow out as for a year now.
So she's born a boy, and then what happens?
They identify as female all along from the beginning.
Well, what do you think about it? Your first haircut.
So far, I'm liking it.
She looks like a girl, huh?
That's because she should have been one.
Yeah.
She is one.
Yeah.
Huh.
You look like a beautiful little girl.
Oh, I just think it's funny. People don't know how to react. They're like, oh, that's lovely. I can't blame them, though.
Well, I just think you are prettier than the picture you picked out. What do you think?
Oh, the back is really cute. Can I see it?
Oh,
it has lots of pearls.
Oh, I love it.
I can't imagine feeling female in every way and looking down and seeing a unit. It'd be like, really? No, she seems pretty aware of things and pretty bright. So probably for her, she's making the right decision.
I washed my hands now.
Okay. Grab one and put them right there.
Allowing Kai to transition from a boy to a girl is a controversial decision, as it has been found that most children with gender dysphoria grow out of it.
How confident are you that Kyla isn't simply showing signs of becoming gay?
Maybe she would have been, but this is what she wanted. She told us that she needed to be a girl. And so I just don't really think that it's...
I don't know. I think it's still a possibility, although it's a very distant possibility from what I've seen from Kai and everything. And I think that's why it is a good idea to use the blockers until, you know, late in the teenage years when they are a little more introspective.
Mm-hmm.
And I think they have the better capability to really know if this is or is not what they are.
Mm-hmm. If she decided she wanted to be a boy at that point, I would be very surprised. But, you know, we'd go with it. What else are you going to do?
Some people might be wondering why you guys allowed Kai to transition so young. What would you say to
that? I could not carry on pretending like this was a boy. It was just not an option.
But we know a lot of people firsthand who their families have rejected them. There's just so much damage caused by non-acceptance. I mean, completely disowning their own children and everything. That kind of blows me away.
And like, we don't want her to be one of those kids that kills themselves because they're so miserable. We want our child. We don't want that.
If I had to wear boys' clothes and be a boy for the rest of my life, I would probably die. Oh my gosh.
Why?
'Cause it's like I couldn't be what I wanted to be. It's like, yeah.
We feel like this is, like, we feel like we're lucky that this is the only thing that's wrong. I mean, it could be so much
harder.
It just could be something so much worse. At least, like, we have our child.
Thank you.
Though Josie loves playing with dolls and painting her nails, she hasn't let go of the toys from when she was a boy.
I'm making that car. I made these two cars. This is to make noise if you open it, and if you push a button, it makes a noise, but it's out of batteries.
What would you say your favorite toys?
This, I glue, I put wax on it, I wax this guy on.
Josie loves toys and all kinds of things that are oftentimes perceived as typically boy or male toys, like dinosaurs. She loves dinosaurs. And I've never discouraged her from having that interest. Just because a man likes to cook doesn't make him a woman, or just because a woman knows how to change the oil on her car doesn't make her a man.
Do you remember what it's like when everyone thought you were a boy and you were really a girl? What was it like?
Sad.
How did you feel about it? Why was it so sad?
Everybody was laughing since I changed into a girl.
Really? What did they do?
They didn't want to play with me.
Oh, how did that make you feel?
Sad.
Did they say mean things?
Yes.
What did they say?
I am a gay boy. Do you know what gay boy means? I don't.
Of course, I have huge concerns for Josie's future. I mean, there are the smaller things like the surgery, it's gonna be painful. Reproductive things are gonna come up. She may wish someday that she could have had her own natural child biologically. Things like that, those aren't necessarily the biggest fears I have though. The bigger fears come from society, the way people are gonna react to her. When she's just living her life and she's maybe a university student, just a normal girl on campus, somebody might say, hey, you're that girl, you're Josie. You're the one born with a penis. I know about you. You know, and people do horrific things.
The idea of boy transitioning to live as a 8 or 9 year old girl, to some of us carries more risks than benefits. When a child reaches puberty, if in fact the need, the wish, the demand, if you will, to be a girl, diminishes, as it does with many children with gender identity disorder, can this child tell everybody, hey, wait, that's enough. This wasn't the right thing to do.
Do you think Josie would ever change her mind and want to be a boy again?
Absolutely not. Josie is so happy right now. She would never change her mind. It wouldn't be an inkling. It wouldn't be a thought. This is her. She's able to express herself so much more now. Now that she's transitioned, she's happier, she's smiling, she's laughing, she's playing, she's interacting with other people, and that's a side of her that we didn't see before. So her life actually began when she transitioned.
What would it be like if someone said, Josie, can you try and be a boy again for like a week and see how it goes?
Very, very sad.
Would it be really hard?
I wouldn't do it.
You wouldn't?
Josie still has time to change her mind and decide if she wants to remain a boy. Chris Mary lives in Toms River, New Jersey with his family. Chris was born female and named Julia. Chris never went through female puberty. At the age of 12, he was given drugs to block it. Chris now takes the hormone testosterone, which has put his body through the puberty of a boy.
Testosterone, I started, I think I was 14. I wanted to start on them like as soon as possible. I was like, I would like see all the kids with like the little tiny voices, and then they were like, "Whoa, what's up?" And I was like, "Well," I was like, I don't think my voice is like that. I'd kind of like it to be like that though." So we started on the hormones, and then by the end, I was starting to sound like the other guys.
Did it take a while to get used to shaving?
I have to do it at least once every week. Otherwise, it's like... I think the best part is just... I kind of like my little hairs. You know, I got my little chesty hairs and my little belly hairs. I mean, I got these little hairs and everything, so it's all good now. I can't even imagine a girl standing right there in the mirror like that, because I just can't. Because, you know, this is who I am. It's who I'm supposed to be. So I can't imagine anything else.
You need to turn around so the camera can see.
Chris's desire to be a boy began when he was 5 years old.
Chris really started expressing his boyness after his dad and I separated. So of course I wondered whether that factored into it. His father would not have allowed him to dress like a boy. So in some ways I think the timing did play into it because he knew I was more accepting.
I thought my sister acted too soon. I thought she jumped into it too soon because as far as I was concerned, as young as she was, I figured it was a phase. Her father was, he had the opinion that women were less than men. So I thought maybe she thought if she were a boy, she'd be more important in her father's eyes. I guess if you hear that enough, you know, and he always said he wanted a boy, he wanted a boy. So I assume if you're a little girl and you want to please your dad, you're going to be what he wants to be.
He wanted a boy, but he didn't want his girl to be like a boy.
My dad, he's still not fully accepting of it. Like, at first, he was, like, totally against it. He's like, no way, no how, you know, you're a girl, God made you a girl, blah, 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 blah. But, I mean, he's come a couple times, he's seen me, you know, he's seen that I'm not really a girl.
From an early age, there were signs that Chris was not comfortable as a girl.
Looking back, he did not play like a typical little girl. I really didn't think too much about it at the time, because for me it was okay. I was going to allow my children to be whoever they were, so if they wanted to play in non-typical ways, that was okay. So it didn't really mean a lot until later on.
I just remember thinking of myself as a boy. Like, I never thought of myself as a girl.
It didn't really distress me until I saw the distress that it was causing him.
Wearing dresses and wearing girl stuff in general, or even thinking about putting on girl stuff, just totally, I don't know, it like creeped me out. I was like, ew, no. It just did not feel right at all.
It didn't feel like a loss until we started talking about transitioning. And I kind of went through in my mind that in some sense it was kind of like I was losing a little girl, losing my child, and then kind of adopting a little boy. It's funny, but in one way, probably one of the most difficult things was the name change. Just the thought of him having a totally different name felt like that would be a total loss, because then I'd have a boy and there'd be no connection to that little girl.
As soon as we started like seeing all the doctors and everything, and it was getting fixed pretty much, like I was able to, you know, talk to doctors, and then the doctor got me the note to go to school as a boy, and then I could like fully transition and be the man I was inside. And then it was just like a relief.
No!
Chris's friends know that he was born female.
When I see Chris, it's pretty much like, it's Chris. He's just any other guy. He's just really easy to get along with, kind of thing. Like, he's outgoing, he'll talk to like anybody, and he's a fun person to be around.
His name is Nathan.
I think one of the difficulties for Chris would be definitely dating, because I don't know how you tell a girl, like, it must be so hard. Like, oh, by the way, I was once a girl. Just letting you know.
Stop!
No.
Let go of my arm. I'm trying to eat. They're not your donuts. They're not your donuts. Would you stop it?
Chris's sister Gina has started to notice that Chris is getting some female attention.
My one friend, she thought Chris was hot. And I'm like, not really. And then my other friend, who's a dude, he's like, you can't deny it, he is. And I'm like, okay. Whatever you say.
He is lucky he got his good looks from his father.
That's true.
At least we don't have to worry about him getting someone pregnant. And if mother's ever concerned about him dating their daughter, we can always say, well, I can guarantee you he won't get her pregnant.
Yeah.
Do you date?
Yeah. I have a girlfriend, you know.
And does she know about?
Yeah, I told her.
Oh, cool. When did you tell her?
I told her after we met. We were just kind of like talking, and I don't remember what it was about. And then I said something about going to New York for the doctor. And she was like, oh, you had to go to New York for a doctor? I was like, yeah. She's like, what kind of doctor? And I was like, oh, here, it's the perfect chance to tell her. And then I told her, and she's like, oh. Like, she just kind of, like she knew me. Like, and she's like, oh, well, you're a really cool guy, so it doesn't really matter. Anything with physical relationships and all, I mean, I'm not thinking about that too much right now. Could be years down the line. Like, why prepare for it now if it's years in advance, you know?
Okay, yeah, put your mouth guard in.
Chris has been enjoying life as a teenage boy. But for a long time, there was something missing, a father figure.
You know you're supposed to keep your hand like this, flat on top.
Like that?
Yeah.
He was put in touch with Evan Davis through a support group.
I don't know.
He needed a mentor, and would I be willing to write to him? So I said, sure.
I have to do another 95 of those. You're gonna be sore tomorrow. Tell me when I can stop.
Evan is also transgender and was born female. At the age of 49, he started taking testosterone, had his breasts removed, and finally began life as a man.
He came for a visit to our house. And then we met him, and, you know, we got to know him a little bit.
That was close.
My first impression of Chris was that he just was like any other boy. That was the way he seemed to me.
He taught me how to tie a tie. And he taught me how to shave. All the important man things. We have some man-to-man discussions. It's pretty fun.
But Chris wasn't the only one taking an interest in Evan.
Every day, she would be like, oh, gotta get off the computer, gotta go get my email from Evan. And I was like, really? Every day? And she's like, yeah, why not? I was like, okay.
Evan made a comment in an email that I just went, whoa, I think he's interested in me. Evan said, I made a comment, you know, kind of thing.
What was his comment?
But, well, he said I had killer cleavage.
They got close. And then now, instead of being my mentor, Now he's like my dad. He's kind of taken over the role of dad for me, because I was never close to my dad. He was never really a dad to me.
When Chris turns 18, he'll be allowed to decide whether to have sex change surgery to remove his ovaries and construct a penis. But even if he has these operations, he'll have to continue taking testosterone for the rest of his life to maintain his masculine appearance.
Okay, you ready?
All right, don't forget the light.
I got it.
Right now, I'm happy with being on testosterone, becoming the man I am inside. So now, pretty much my biggest issue is just trying to deal with normal life and balancing work and school and friends and all that.
Just as I found Evan, that Chris will find someone who will fall in love with Chris, and it won't matter that he's transgender.
What do you want to be when you grow up?
A mommy.
A mommy? How many children do you want to have?
One.
Just one? Will it be a boy or a girl?
A girl.
I want the chocolate one with nuts. But Mama, could I get a syrup on it?
When I grow up, I want to be full girl. Long red hair. Slim. So it's like I just want to be like a normal person. And so, yeah.